Okay, now I am going to find the force. How much force is there? Okay, measuring the force. If you want to measure the force, you need the first, you know about the system. So there are different types of systems will be exist in the physics. Then that lessons, you might have studied in the lower classes. Okay, that lesson, what we can say, measurement of system. Measurement of system is in the physics. For the physics, the measurement of system, one sense we can say, the measurement of system for physics, art. So that is, now we are going to derive the measurement. Okay, we are arriving the three types of measurement. First one is CGS. Measurement for what? Force. Force, how we are measuring, that we are seeing. First one is CGS, second one is MKS, next third one is PS, foot pound second. Okay, C stands for centimeter, G stands for grams, S stands for seconds, next M stands for meter, K stands for kilograms, S stands for seconds, next V stands for foot pound second. Okay, nowadays we are not using this one, only we are using the CGS and MKS. So another name also is there, MKS. So in our home, generally child is there. Okay, we will give one name. Okay, another people also, they will call some petty names. Like that also, they have given another name that we are calling the SI unit. There is no difference between MKS system and SI system, system unit. So now we'll see, now we'll derive the force. Okay, in the CGS system, which measurement is there for force? In the MKS system, which measurement is there for force? And if you derive, then we can say, okay. So here the force, the Newton is given here, force we can write here dyne. So here also the for force is given Newton, or else we can write directly force is equal Newton, here force equal dyne. Keep this. Okay, now don't disturb. Okay, what is the formula here? F is equal to ma. So you are in which measurement? You are in CGS measurement. Okay, right. M means which one? Grams. Next, acceleration. What is the formula? Acceleration, velocity by time. Velocity means first distance by time. Distance by time. Distance means centimeters. T means seconds. Oh, you got the velocity. What you got? Velocity meter by seconds. Now you got the velocity. Next, A is equal, what is that? Meter by second. What is that down? What is there? T is there. Again, what you are getting? S. SS gets cancelled? No, not like that. A by B by C by D. Then what we can write simply? Keep IST. Don't disturb this term. A by B. Then reciprocal of this. D by C. Like that we can write. Okay, finally what happened? Acceleration. Meter by second square. So what you got here? Meter by second square, or else we can write gram centimeter second inverse 2. This is which measurement? Force. What is the force? CGS measurement, gram centimeter second inverse 2. Okay, if you consider this is a equation 1, if you consider this is a equation 2, if you compare the equation 1 and 2, then what we can write? Here also force is there, here also force is there. The force measurement is given by the Newton in the CGS method, that is dyne. So if nothing is there, means in front of, can I write 1 into something, means then that something only get here. What is there? The something dyne is there. 1 into dyne means 1 dyne only. Now I am going to, from equation 1 and 2, from equation 1 and 2, then what we can write? Tell me, 1 dyne is equal to how much? Gram centimeter by second. This is the equation number 3. Okay, already we got. Okay, after solving this, then we can derive that 1 dyne is equal to how much value we are having. Next, 1 Newton is equal to how much value we are having. Next, we'll see here. Next come to the SI unit. Okay, same thing. This is the equation number 1. Next, what is the formula? F is equal to ma. M means, what is this M? Mass. How we are measuring mass here? Kg. Next, what is this A? Acceleration. Acceleration, what is the formula? Same formula, velocity by time. Then velocity is equal to, what is the formula? Distance by time. Distance, how we are measuring? Yeah, meter by second. Then again, what happened? Meter by second by second. Then what happened? Meter per second square. What is the difference between here and there? Means, sorry, what I have written here? Meter, centimeter will come here. Why? Because this is distance. How we are measuring? Centimeter. Here also centimeter. Then what you are getting? Here also centimeter. Why? Because this C stands for centimeter, M stands for meter by second square. One dyne is equal to gram centimeter by second square. So here what you are writing? A is equal to how much? Meter by second square. Then what happened? Kg meter second inverse 2. Both are same only. Either you can take this is the equation number 2. Okay, now from equation 1 and 2. So now we got the equation 3. So now I am going to find one dyne is equal to how much? One dyne is equal to how much? And 1 newton is equal to how much? Why I am going to tell about this is, this is useful for in solving problems. You have to remember this value. Okay, sometime if you are unable to remember one dyne is equal to how much, 1 newton is equal to how much. Okay, best example, take this process and derive yourself, then write in the exam nicely. Okay, after solving the problem, if you don't write the measurements, you will lose the mark. If you have done correctly also, suppose you got 20 answer, what is a 20? That is newton or dyne, you should mention, then only you will get the full marks. That's why I am saying, if you forget also, our theory is there, how I said here, remember this, then you can derive yourself. If you are able to recollect the F is equal to MA formula, you know CGS method as well as MKS method, from that derive yourself. Okay, now I am going to tell about one dyne is equal to how much and one newton is equal to how much. So let us take best example. One newton is equal to, what is there? Kg meter by second square. Okay, this I have considered here. This I am considered. So next, 1 kg is equal to how much? You know very well. 1 kg is equal to 1000 grams. This is over. Next, what is the next one? Meter is there. 1 meter is equal to how much? 100 centimeters. So just nothing is there. 1 newton is equal to, I have taken here kg. Next, meter by second square. 1 kg is equal to how much? 1000 grams. 1 meter is equal to how much? 100 centimeters. Now I am substituting here in the kg place 1000 grams. In the meter place, I am substituting 100 centimeters. Next, kg is equal to how much is there? 1, 2, 3 grams. Next, meter place how much is there? 100 centimeters. By what is there? Second square. Next. What happened here? Here how many zeros are there? 3 zeros are there. Here how many zeros are there? 5 zeros. Then what we can write? 10 to the power of 5 gram centimeter by second square. This is which equal to 1 N also we can write. So be carefully observe this is. Okay. Gram centimeter by second square. Where is the gram centimeter by second square? Okay, it is there in the CGS system. Gram centimeter by second square. That equal to how much is there? Dyne. Okay, from CGS method, gram centimeter by second square is equal to 1 dyne. Okay, in this place write, or what you can write simply 1 dyne. Then what happened? 1 newton is equal to how much? 10 to the power of 5